I'm Firefighter John Straseskie, Engine 3 C-Shift, and behind the mask, I'm a runner. It's important to run, and I enjoy running primarily because, as we all know, it's an inherent part of what we do. It prepares me for our day-to-day duties. Mentally, what I've found is through running, I've been able to set goals for myself, to push myself to what I think would be my limit, and to push myself a little bit further past that, to find ways to improve. The more notable races that I've run have been with the Marine Corps series. I've run the Marine Corps Half Marathon in Fredericksburg twice, as well as the Marine Corps Marathon, the full marathon twice. Some of the challenges with these races are primarily running in a crowd. It's a whole different animal. And also, there's been quite a few hills and obstacles that we had to work around. Sharp turns, U-turns in the race course, and things that you don't typically see around home. Big motivation for me as far as running these long distances would be my brother Kirk and my memory of my brother Kirk. Kirk is a Marine Sergeant, the 1st Battalion, 4th Marine Regiment in Camp Pendleton. Kirk was a very special individual, one of the best kind-hearted, genuine people I've ever known, and one of the hardest workers. Kirk approached everything that he did as if the whole war effort depended on it. Whatever his task was, he was going to perform it at the best of his ability. I always had, even as an older sibling, I had the respect and admiration that you would typically have for an older sibling. Kirk is 5 years younger than me, but I continually looked at him as a role model just because of the way that he approached life. I think the thing that made me most proud of Kirk, particularly in his high school years, was the fact that I don't believe that social lines existed for him. Kirk was an all-conference athlete, football and wrestling. You would typically see him with his football jersey on, having lunch with some special needs students at school. He had a big heart, and he had a lot of compassion for people that were weaker than him, which ultimately was just about everybody. May 19th, 2003, Kirk's unit was in a sort of a defensive position about 50 miles south of Baghdad. In fact, they were near the ruins of Babylon. They were advanced party during the invasion. They made their push through Baghdad, and there was actually the announcement by President Bush that major combat operations had been over. At this point, our family and friends had that big collective sigh of relief that this is finally over and these guys are going to be packing up and heading home soon. On that day, my brother was heading along a riverbank when a Sea Knight helicopter had begun having some difficulty in the air, a lot of problems. That aircraft ultimately crashed into the water, and in this particular body of water, the currents were horrible, from what I was told from people that were on scene. My brother and another Marine dove into the water upstream and had reached the aircraft before it became submerged in the water. At that point, Kirk had difficulty staying above water and ultimately drowned. He was pulled out of the water by some Iraqi civilians who had came in with one of their boats, and they'd taken him to the shock trauma unit there, and at which point he was pronounced dead. I use running to honor Kirk, just by getting out there and pushing myself. As everybody who's run races knows, it takes a lot of commitment to train for these events, particularly for someone in my situation I have 5 children. It's difficult to get out and run. A lot of times training takes place after 9 p.m. or at 4:30 in the morning. But that was the kind of commitment that he made toward everything that he did. I think I've tried to use Kirk's memory to help people both on and off duty. Of course, we're always going to people on their worst day to help them on the job, off duty. That never stops, and that just goes for firefighters in general. Whether you're on duty or off, you're still a firefighter, and you're still out there to try to help people. I think memory of my brother and the running that I do plays into what I do as a firefighter. I want to come into the station every day and treat my duties with the same commitment that he did, for the reasons that he did. I want to position myself in life where I can daily help people, and we definitely do that. I have a commitment to the community and to brothers and sisters in the department. I would have to say, with the running and with what I do as a firefighter, I feel like my brother be looking down at me, feeling proud of what I'm doing. I think he would be appreciative of my efforts to help out kids and help out people that are just going through tough times. I think he would definitely be appreciative of the honor and respect that I feel for his beloved Marine Corps. I think he'd be proud of what his nieces and nephews are going to be.